CP, you're it, my CP.
What we've seen just now is a simulation-based training of transporting a patient from the intensive care into the computer tomography unit. This is based on a true story where we almost lost a patient due to a medical error of the team during this transport mission. Let's admit it, medical errors are much too common these days in the healthcare system. Most of us have encountered a medical error at one time or another. In fact, medical errors are the number three cause of death after cancer and heart disease. Current estimates show that 250,000 to 400,000 people die annually in US hospitals only because of medical errors. It's equivalent to three Boeing 747s crashing daily in the United States. If planes were that unsafe, we probably would never fly. Speaking of flying, I was a fighter pilot in the Israeli Air Force. Pilots are being trained on simulators. After every flight, we went straight into the debriefing room in order to reflect on our performance so that we will do better in our next mission. When I went into medicine, I was shocked at the huge difference in safety culture, although both medicine and aviation carry the same high risk and low tolerance to error. In the year 2000, I was recruited to Sheba Medical Center to serve as deputy director responsible for patient safety. Based on my Air Force experience, it was only natural to apply simulation-based safety culture in medicine. This evolved into the establishment of MESR, the Israel Center for Medical Simulation. MESR is a cultural change vehicle, a safe place to err and to reflect. Simulation at MESR allows health professionals to meet their worst nightmares as a means to increase preparedness, not just to heroic clinical emergencies like resuscitation, but also with complex communication, such as delivering difficult and at times devastating news to patients and their loved ones. Messer in Hebrew means a message of value, the value of being humbled and well-prepared. We aim at training health professionals from all disciplines and at all levels. And we are using all types of simulation modalities, from high-tech virtual reality simulators to improve our clinical skills, all the way to the high-touch role-playing actors that enable us to improve our communication skills. And a bit like Hollywood, we create all types of environments, operating rooms, clinical wards, and even battlefields.
ועכשיו למדתי משהו חדש שיכול להיות שישפיע על הטיפול, זה דבר הכי מבורך.
אם אני משקיע בללמד את הרופאים הצעירים האלה להיות רופאים טובים יותר, כשהם מסיימים את הפרק של השירות הצבאי שלהם והופכים להיות רופאים במערכת הבריאות האזרחית, שמטפלים בך כאזרח, הם יהיו כאלה שמאפשרים לעצמם ללמוד מטעויות.
Key to the design of MESR is a reflective atmosphere. One-way mirrors, over 100 cameras, and a customized debriefing software. Self-reflection is perhaps the most precious gift MESR offers its trainees.
CPR American Heart.
Critical events are rare, even in critical care. So a patient crashes not every hour, not every day even. But when they crash, we need the team to be at their best. Here, we can actually do that over and over and over again and take the most rare cases, bring them here and have the team see exactly how to deal with these type of events.
What's interesting is that at the beginning of the simulation, people were afraid. I don't want to be recorded, I'm afraid of being taped. But after doing it for many times, they actually ask for it. They like the simulation because we do it in a way that we want to improve. and they see it as a chance to see themselves and how they can improve.
I was training here at Mesa 1,000 times before on resuscitation, but never on a real patient. And when I encountered that situation, I was like a robot. I knew everything, what to do, how to handle the equipment, which are the steps. I managed the whole operation there. Ever since, if there's a resuscitation or a problem, they call me. They know that I'm there for them.
Watching you in real time.
Israel has become a world leader in the use of simulation-based education as a mandatory tool and has trained faculty from all over the world. Mesa is a key player in Israel's emergency preparedness. Trauma management in Israel has improved dramatically, both on the civilian and the military fronts. But no less important is the essential role that Mesa plays in improving the humane and dignified approach to patients and families.
אם אני לגעת בית החולים.
שהיה לו שלשול בשלשול לא מתים!
אני מרגישה נורא, נורא עם מה שקרה. כשתגיד לי מה כרגע אני יכולה לעזור לך.
אני לא יודע. תגיד לי. מה אני יכול להיכונן לכאן?
תודה לכם.
תודה לך. שלא יקרה לנו.
Changing the safety culture is a lengthy journey. We all have the right to safer and better healthcare services. To achieve this, we, healthcare professionals, must know our limitations and remain humble. For to err is human, but to improve and grow from our errors is a must.